So let's just emphasize, we have two possible directions we take from here. The first one is, I'll try to actually write this down as I say it, just to also organize things in my mind, which I do as I go along with the video. So one thing we could actually try and do is to do the PCA approach, and to combine that with the geodesic distances, so actually taking the distances we already know how to handle, geodesic, okay, geodesic, and basically then try and use the distances we have inside a shape and use to represent them using the PCA approach. This will be interesting for all sorts of reasons. I think it's a natural way of handling geodesic distances for two reasons. One thing you can do is to try and use the PCA process to find the points to better suit your needs, without necessarily using all kinds of kernel and heat functions and whatever to find points in a very automated, silly way. You could actually optimize over, you can actually use the PCA to calculate the complexity of the distribution. Then based on that you could change the points or reparameterize the points in all the shapes that you have, and get automatically an improved set of points. That's the work of Rodri Davis way back in 2003 to 2006. He still publishes in this area based on this method. So the second thing you could actually try and do though is to compare a pure PCA approach to the problem of GMDS, and I'll explain this in the next video. Let's move this quick here.